So I'm Centurion Rider again, and just got out of school and riding with my buddy. He's gone. And second vlog. This time a little bit better weather and all that. On my dear yard again, and I'm going to get some money on the bank so I can buy some new parts and do my license for my car and all that. Where I left the last time, it was what was it again? I don't know, really know it anymore, but I think it was with the fines. That when you go too fast, you get a hefty fine. A hefty fine. So I'm gonna try to change that subject today, and we'll be talking about a bit of Belgium and all that, and what's it like here. At the moment, a lot of road work, so it's a bit confusing at times from where to go and all that, and it takes too long for everything to get finished, and okay. That's what. In Belgium, for once in this week, the sun shines, and it's pretty good outside, and it's pretty fun to drive. But as you can see, it was raining in the morning today, and you can still see it everywhere, and shame of that, but if you don't deal with it, you better not ride. I drive almost every day of all the year. All the time I can drive, I will drive. And I am driving now for about 4 years, and I had 7 bikes in total. Most of them I rebuilt, and I'm a plumber from education. And a mechanic in my spare time, just for two-stroke bikes and that. But I'm learning to get how to do 4-strokes and do all of it, all the maintenance and all that, and just to learn, because it's fun. I do almost everything myself, only the tires. I tried that, didn't work. Destroyed 2 tires and lost about 200 euros and all that. And since then, I always let the professionals do it. For 5 euros, you can change your tires. Whoa. I think I need to go get some gas soon. I think it's almost empty. Yep, it's almost empty. Where was I? Driving for 4 years now, and going for my A2 license. for the 600cc, the 25 to 35 kilowatts, the 50 horsepower range. And I'm trying to go for that when I'm 20. Thinking of an MT3, KTM Duke, and 390 or something like that, something with white handlebars or something. No race bike or such like that, because it's too hard to do your exams. And to learn, it's better to have a white steering wheel. And yeah, I think I have a rattle somewhere. Don't know where, but something rattles. Now I'll check in it when I'm home. I built my bikes myself, and at the moment I have four bikes. This one, they are the limited edition from 2007, and Derbi SM with our setup, so for cross and for off-roading and all that, and then a special one, 94 Senda, the first model, the new concept G. It's something special, it drives fun, but
it's old.
But it's the only one that is fully original, nothing done with it, absolutely 100% original, and it drives and it works perfect. About 10,000 kilometers. I bought it for 50 euros at the local junkyard. I thought maybe the engine I could use it for one of my bikes, and I got home, started to test some things, and I switched the battery, the lights worked, everything worked, and I got further and further. With every last minor thing I changed, like new fuses, and everything worked. I cleaned the carburetor, and it fired right up. Really insane. Put a lot of oil in the gas extra, because you don't assure that there is enough oil in the system from the oil pump, and you don't want your engine to blow up, I think. I don't like that to happen, but for 50 euros, a complete bike. Only need to change the fuses, a few light bulbs, a battery, and the front brake, and also a new chain, because there wasn't one. And the gun, I went to the dealership asking for new papers, the certificate of the bike. 75 euros, I had a new certificate. So I had a complete bike for 200 euros. How cool is that? I never had that. A full working bike for under 200 euros. By the way, for everyone that's in Belgium, it's for sale. I put a pickup here. And it's a fine bike. Perfectly for someone who is learning. Because it's fully original. And it drives great. It's super soft, the brakes are good. Not as good as this one, but that's dual calipers. So yeah, that's a little bit different. But let's go do that today. Let's go for a tour, so I can vlog a little bit longer than yesterday. When I do my vlogs, I will ask you, what do you want to hear, and what do you annoy yourself on, and what do you find bad, what do you find good on my vlogs? This is my second vlog, so it's hard for me to do this. Yeah, I really don't know what to do. Because, yeah, I didn't do it yet. All those other vloggers who have 100 or so videos or more, they know what to do, but I don't, and that's a little bit annoying. And yeah, I'll try to do my best, but nobody's perfect. And yeah, but if you if you want to hear something about me or my bikes or something, just put it in the comments and I will contact you as soon as I can. So a little bit more about me. I live in the country. Actually, a few miles outside the city. And I love it here because it's quiet. I can do what I want, and nobody points a finger. When I go too fast, nobody notices, and yeah, really, I shouldn't do that to going too fast. But yeah, who can let it? If you need to go 30, you go 50. When you need to go 50, you go 70. And when you go 70, I go 70 because my bike isn't fast. So yeah, but I love to drive, and wait a second. I live from the at the side of Mechelen in Belgium. It's one of the bigger cities between Antwerp and Brussels. It's right between those two big cities, and everyone knows Brussels because what the scramble is this? I'm not supposed to do that, but who cares? More about me. I love to drive two strokes just because of the power. I like four stroke too, but only in the high cc's, because a 50cc four stroke isn't that fun. And yeah, my buddy has a 140cc four stroke. Yeah. It's leaving me behind in this, but yeah, that's his choice on a bike that's about 50 centimeters high with almost 20 horsepower. Yeah, it's not the best choice, but it's possible. And yeah, if you want to do that, you just gotta do that. Two strokes, I don't find them better than four strokes. They have their advantages, but they also have their downsides. Like this one, very, very heat sensitive. When it's cold, it doesn't start that easily. When it's hot, it doesn't dry that good. But when it's just perfect, oh, she's a rocket. A four stroke? It consumes much less gas, and yeah, it's more stable than a two-stroke. In two-stroke, you need to keep you need to keep the RPMs high enough so you don't stall. In four-stroke you can go to 1000 or so. In this I can't go under 6000 because she just stalls. It happened just yet when I passed the little kid, she stalled. And yeah, that's pretty easy because I just let go of the clutch and she starts up again. But when you're just driving, you let go of the throttle and you just, yeah, I'll show you. See? No power level anymore. Full power. Hey. Nothing. But when you downshift, that was in third, eh? In third, or 3000 or so RPM, nothing. This is even an original exhaust, so it should have some torque, but nothing. I think I'm gonna change the exhaust, maybe in a week or so, because yeah, I'm getting bored on the bike again and it doesn't drive the right way, in my opinion. My previous bike, yeah, the previous engine that was underneath it, I couldn't go more than quarter of throttle because it was gone. It was too powerful, and yeah, you adjust to that, and now you have to go full throttle with everything you do, and it just annoys me. So should I let my boss? So yeah, but we're trying to go to 660 soon, and yeah, I'll be vlogging decently then on that side of the road. In the road, on the roads itself, not on the lane for the cyclists, because I need to go on this road because I can't drive there. Only within the city limits I can drive there, and I hate it. In my previous engine, I did just drove there on the road because I was fast enough. I could keep up with every car there was. I was faster than most. When I started, then no one ever actually came close because it was just so fast. A simple car couldn't catch me. And yeah, it was fun. But yeah, it's dangerous. If you go on 50cc with 22.7 horsepower, it's just insane. And just dangerous. And yeah, not a very brilliant idea to do. She's lacking power today. Come on, grandma. Yep. Don't get a branch against my head. Cute dog. Yeah, more about me, I'm a big animal fan, especially for felines, cats and all that. I have a cat myself, a little one. I was a pig soon, and yeah, it's the cutest one, and it's really attached to me and to me alone, and that's the fun of it, because she always comes to me. My mom has her cat, I have mine. My parents are separated, so yeah, they're divorced when I was about 3 years old. And yeah, but I don't really care because I didn't know anything else because that they were divorced. I always know it like this, and it doesn't care. I really don't care. Because yeah, I'm fine, and I always have a place to go. when I'm partying somewhere, I can always go sleep at my dad's because I have a key of my own room. It's a separate building. Super easy, super fun. I can do whatever I want here, actually. But the only thing they demand is if I want something, I gotta work for it. And I get that because money just doesn't grow on trees. For the most things, it's fairly expensive. I always worked from everything I wanted, always. So some of the people at school call me a spoiled cunt. Sorry, I can't say that, but I really am. Don't them. Because I work for everything I own. I've worked for everything I wanted. And always I bought everything myself, because just it was mine then. And no one can say what to do with it. The bikes too, the only bike I got was the first one. And it was a birthday present. He promised it 3 years earlier, and I totally forgotten about it. And as my father is, he keeps his promises. He always has, he always will, because it's like he's like me. I'm an honest guy. I say what I'm thinking. I will always stay rather polite, not always, but most of the time. But I will stay polite, I will stay more than I'm thinking. I always will. Because why shouldn't? It's a free country, so you can say what you want as long as it's decent. Now I'm gonna have some fun. A little bit faster. Come on, girl, let's see what you got. I love playing with my bike, and I'm really a big kid. I act like I'm 12 because I can. I don't know everything myself, so yeah. For everyone that loves to drive and get to share this with people, and it feels just right. And so if you drive, you can follow me on Facebook. I'm with the Centurion Rider. I have a page, I have a profile. You can always send me a pic, you can always talk to me. I really don't care, I will accept everyone. If I don't like you, I'll just delete you. So I'm honest in that. If I don't like you, I just delete you. On a page, I don't care. But on the profile, I see what I do, and most of the time it will be in Dutch. But I can almost talk perfectly in English. My accent isn't too great, but I understand it, I can write it, I can talk it, clearly. It's not perfect, so I need some time, sometimes I need time to think. I can pretty much talk English in the right way. I don't know really what accent I have, but my language is Dutch, so one of the hardest languages in the system. But yeah. So Well, let's have some fun, and I hope I get some scrubs more, because yeah, I had only 9, and I'm trying to get that up. I want, at the end of this year, I at least want 200 or so, at least. And yeah, we'll see. I will also try to drive other bikes and yeah, do some comments on them, and let's see what I can drive. My thoughts on the bike or something like that, like a lot of others. Sorry, a bit of acid in my stomach. So I'll do reviews. I'll try to buy some stuff and test it out, and hope most of it is that I like it. Because at this moment, I will not be earning anything with YouTube. So in the future, I will be, hopefully, will be able to buy things with the profit I get from YouTube and put it in the channel itself. And I really don't do it because I want the profit out of it. I will do it because I like to do it. I like to drive, and yeah, I want to share it with everyone. And really, that being honest, the profits is just a bonus. It pays for the gas. That's expensive enough. Yeah, so this is where we left off yesterday, so the last time. And yeah, Centurion out.